Good morning. It is 2:18 in the morning.
Now, normally, I would have just slept in because I hit my workouts before work, so I probably would have just slept in. But here's the thing. I've been getting like 8 hours of sleep for like 2 weeks straight. So the fact that I'm missing sleep only on one night out of those 2 weeks... is it really necessary? I don't think so.
So we're gonna be training legs beat this week. Doing push pull legs arms, today's legs. Legs B, here we go. See him curls to start. I got my little list right here. I'll even show it to you.
This is how I do it. I just print it right out, straight from the library. It's like 30 cents for 8 pages, cut them up in half. I got 4 weeks of programming right here. So. Let's get it started. This is what we got on the list. We got C-ham curls, the hip abductor out, the hip abductor in on the rower machine, and then the leg extension. We're cutting weight so we can lower our volume a lot. So, because we're only maintaining, that's about it.
So as you can see on that machine, the lengthened partials that we do are very, very long lengthened partials. This one and the lying leg extension are both good to train the lengthened position. Planet Fitness doesn't really have much, well, you know, it does. It does have good hamstring exercises. You can always do deadlifts and stuff. I'm kind of limited on my leg exercises due to my low back. So this is really all I can do right now is this machine, the lion hamstring curl, and then the, what is it called, the cable Nordic or something, I don't know what it's called, just the cable extension where I got it, where I have it around my ankles, and I do it standing, and it's like a unilateral movement. Even though our volume is very low, we are still training to failure, and we're training with intent, and we're training very radically. So if I mess up a set, then it's game over pretty much. I can't mess up a set at all. If I do, I'm probably just gonna restart it right away. But we're gonna move on to the next thing, which is the outward hip abductor machine. Let's take a seat. And it's pretty much, this is great for accessory lifts. And why can't I see my face? Alright, anyways, very underrated machine, great accessory lift, especially if you're limited on leg exercises due to low back pain. This is a wonderful machine. Not a lot of people use it. I believe if you put your heel on it, it will actually make it a little more difficult. Yeah.
almost feels like it hits a different part of your leg too when you use your heels. It almost feels like you're getting more activation, like in the size of your glutes. I don't know what that is. I don't think it's the glute max. I don't know. Somebody correct me on that. But yeah, this is what we're doing. We're just gonna start out with a little warm up set. When I warm up on everything, I like to just go three or four reps on the first one, and then I like to just lower the weight a little bit, and then maybe do two or three for my warm up, and then on the weight that I'm ready to use, I'll do one rep. So this is generally the weight that I want to use right here. Yeah, that's what we want to use. When you're doing this machine, just be careful, because your hips might start feeling it. The ligaments in your hips might be like, hey, you should chill out a little bit. And yeah, just lower the weight. If you never used this machine before, I recommend you do endurance reps, because I don't know about you, but my hips, they're not insanely good, right? I don't got the worst hips, but my hips will definitely be screaming at me if I just get on this machine and just start hammering them. But for the most part, once you start getting better at it, the weight will start to come really easily, especially if you got good leg genetics and good leg strength. So, in between my set, you quickly saw me make a little weight adjustment in this, and then I wanted to drop the weight mid-set, which is totally fine to do. I dropped the weight a little bit, and I continued on with my set because I wasn't going to be hitting that hypertrophic threshold of 8 to 10 reps. I was probably going to fail at around 5 or 6. It's all right to drop the stack a little bit mid-set. Do it real quick, get right back at it. Moving on to the hip abductor, the inwards one. They got the hip abductor machine back there, but that's trained in the shortened position. You want to train in all three positions, the shortened, the lengthened, and the mid. So this one's going to train the lengthened. This machine's not even made for doing hip abductors, but bear with me here, because this is actually a pretty good exercise that I like to do that I just started incorporating. So this is the rower machine right here. They have these at most gyms, and it's the one that comes back like this, and then it just starts to slide forward a little bit. We're not going to be rowing on this. We're going to be doing something different. Right here. I don't even have to explain it. You can just watch. Oh, I guess I'll explain it. You get like this, and then you just start going in. Just go as far as your mobility will allow you to, and then just come back up, and you should feel it in this one. It's isolating like this inner quad muscle, I don't know what it's called. Somebody tell me in the comments or something. Anyways, this is a great exercise though. I really like using this. If you can't do it like that, the way I did it, if you lose your balance or for whatever reason you just can't do it, use a stick. Just find a stick. Thank you.
Set our timer. Usually when I set my timer, I generally know how long it takes me to feel my muscles not be as fatigued anymore. I know when I'm training my quads and my thighs, 4 minutes is good. Generally, I like to do 4 minute rests for most of my exercises. Unless I'm drop setting or doing myo reps or whatever, then I'll probably rest for a longer time. Alright, this is my favorite exercise out of every single exercise I could possibly do in the gym. Of course, it's gonna be last. That's how I want it. On the leg extension, seems like you can go on this thing for forever, pretty much. Right. That'd be pretty cool if I could do like a 2 minute set of just repping out. And it's hard to mess up your form on this machine as well. As long as you keep your butt on the seat and you do a full range of motion rep, and you're pretty good. And you gotta make sure that you set up right too. And how I like to do that is, I pretty much like to make sure that the back of my knee is on the edge of the seat. And then keep it at a light weight just to figure out how our range of motion is gonna feel. So this feels pretty good. I usually like to keep it right above the ankles, so right above the ankles, and then this one, this adjustment, I like to just put it all the way back so I can get obviously a full range of motion. We're gonna do a quick warm up and then we're just gonna blast our legs. So I did do this machine last week. I don't remember what weight I did, so this is when this comes into play, because I can just go back and see what I did last week without going on my phone. I hate going on my phone. I get so distracted when I'm on my phone, so. All right, last week we did 120 pounds, so we're gonna up that weight by, we're gonna do 125. Even though we're cutting weight, we still wanna be progressing. I think I did 13 reps.
maybe 12, but we hit what we wanted to hit. We did 12 plus, so we got to 13. So that's good enough. And then, this week we did pretty good. This day we did pretty good. We pretty much fell into our threshold on reps that we wanted besides the hip abductor machine.
We're still gonna be here for about another hour, actually. We're cutting weight, so we're gonna do some cardio. But first, we are going to mobilize my back. I'm doing the Stuart McGill, the big three. So I'll do that. I'll do a quick rundown on that real quick. It's nothing crazy. Now for core. This is not part of my back mobilization, and I do have good ab genetics. I think my abs are the only part of my body that I have good genetics in, besides my triceps. It's literally my triceps and my abs. Everything else just does not grow, really. So it's time for me to glorify my abs. All the exercises are funny looking, but you're gonna see growth if you do them, for sure. You grow when you do them, so it's all that matters. So I generally like to do my mobility first before my core, because pretty much just warms up for the core exercise. There is absolutely no point in me wearing headphones because they are gonna fly right out of my ears. When you're training your abs, you pretty much want to be constantly moving your body, moving your core to failure. And it's pretty much like a competition as to how many times you can go to failure when you're training. And then eventually, once that starts getting easy and it takes you like 10 minutes just to fail, it takes you like 10 minutes just to go to failure like once, then you can start adding in weight.
Alright, so 30 minutes is all we got today on the stair stepper. I was training at 11, I just sent it down to 1 though. So I'm getting ready to wrap it up and call it a day at the gym. We are out of here. So I don't know if you can see me or not, but when I'm driving, I got my big bag, which I'll show you another time. But it's pretty much my lunch bag. I put my gallon of water in it. It's actually so heavy that it thinks that there's a person sitting next to me. I set my camera right on top of it. That's how I'm able to film like that. But I have to actually buckle the seatbelt in for it so my car doesn't keep bugging me. There. So, due to my lifestyle and what I chose to do for work, my hours are long at work and my drives are also long too. I actually have an hour and a half drive to the job site. So there's a lot of fun activities I can do while I drive that will also help with muscle growth and maybe even testosterone and just stuff I like to do on my way to work so I'm not bored. And I don't have to waste time when I do it when I get home. So I eat and drive. I'm sure a lot of people do this as well. But if you're always
always pressed on time. You're always just, you always go to bed and you never have enough time. You're always losing sleep. Just look at your schedule and figure out what can give you more time in your day. And for me personally, it's good if I have a lot of activities to do while I drive. I know a lot of people don't live that lifestyle where they're driving very far to work and they're working more than 8 hours a day. But, I mean, even if you do feel like you're pressed for time and you only work a part-time job, and you're only driving 30 minutes to work, this can still apply to that too. You know, so we're just gonna peel this bad boy open. Here we got our apple. Low calorie fruits. The banana wasn't really much of a low calorie fruit. But this is. Secret to keeping your hormones on track while you're cutting weight is to be in the mindset of get in and get out when you're cutting weight. You want to get in to the cutting weight process and then you want to get out as soon as possible. I'm trying to do a 1 month mini cut, but I'm actually cutting so much weight I don't know if I'll be able to make it within a month. I'm gonna do it quickly so I have more room for bulking. When I have more room for bulking, I have more room for healthy fats. I have more room for more calories. More calories, more nutrients. So right now I'm on a bit of a nutrient deficiency. I'm eating healthy still. I'm still getting my chicken. I'm still getting my fruits. I'm still getting my milk. I'm still getting my eggs. Just in a lower amount. Oh, you could supplement. If you're cutting weight, you probably want to actually supplement a little bit more. Like actually taking like the dietary supplements that the pill form that you swallow. I would recommend Shilajit. I will be making a video on that in the future. Get apples that look like they just came out of a tree. Don't get the shiny ones. I don't get why they make their apples shiny. Like, what is that gonna do? Does that really look more appetite? Eat your whole foods, no matter if you're bulking or cutting. It's gonna run you a little bit more money, so if you're willing to spend that money, then spend it. And this is coming from a hormone regulation-based diet to help better produce more testosterone in your body. If you're just in the bodybuilding world and your hormones are fine, then go ahead. You can literally dirty bulk all you want. I don't care. But ever since I've been eating whole foods, my testosterone levels have been going up.